Hi people, this is our devotion for today, and I want to read from the Gospel of John in chapter 10, verse 10, Jesus speaking, "The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I have come that they may have life and have it to the full." From this verse, we see in the statement of Jesus, the two major players in life. First, he talks about the thief. Who is the thief? That's Satan. And Satan has come to steal, kill, and destroy. On the other hand, there is Jesus, and he says that he has come to give us life, not just life, but life to the full. Now, what's been going on right now all over the world, not just here in the Philippines, but everywhere, is this COVID-19 thing that has been having many people get sick, having many people even die. Some people, unfortunately, would attribute this as an act of God, that God is actually mad at the world and is judging the world. Now, all we need to do is just go back to the basics of our faith. And the basics of our faith, if you remember, when we were young children, we were told that God is good and the devil is bad. It's as simple as that. God is good and the devil is bad. You just need to look at the fruit, and by the fruit you will know. So Jesus is saying the thief, Satan, and all of his demons, they have come to steal, kill, and destroy. Now what is this COVID-19 doing? It is stealing lives, it is stealing joy, it is stealing peace away from people. So that's the work of the thief. It steals, it kills, it destroys. It has destroyed even the economy of the whole world. So for people, even believers, Christians, to attribute this COVID-19 as a handiwork of God or as the judgment of God, this is in violation of the basic truth that Jesus has spoken in His Word. Again, let's go back to what Jesus said in John 10:10, the thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. We don't want to highlight the thief. Let's look at what Jesus came to do. He says, "I have come so that you might have life, and that to the full." For all of these things that have happened, lahat ng sakit, maski yung namatay, lahat ng nawala ng pera, the businesses that have gone down, all of these things, I say, let's come against it in the name that is higher above every name, the name of Jesus, and let's start declaring life the way Jesus has promised it to all of us. In Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11, God is very clear about it, that He has a plan for all of us, a plan to prosper us, not to harm us, a plan to give all of us hope and the future. And Lord, we come to you, and that is what we declare for this planet, for the entire world, even for the Philippines, God. We are asking, let your wonderful plan of full life, abundant life, happen once again. We rebuke the works of the enemy in the name of Jesus, and we say, come, Lord Jesus, have your way in this world. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. God bless you, people. Keep in touch. Pray to the Lord. Read your Bible. Be in love with Jesus. God bless you.